Right over here, Mr. Hughes. This way, over to the left.
Mr. Hughes, how was your flight? Miss Hepburn, when are you gonna name the day?
Right over here, Mr. Hughes. Could you raise your head a little? What's the next movie, Howard? Come on, give us a scoop.
Right here, Howard.
How many more records are you gonna set?
Right over here, Mr. Hughes. Come on, Howard. Give us a smile. It won't kill you.
Howard, this way. Beautiful.
Raise your head a little.
Over here. Mr. Hughes, what's don't forget this movie, side.
Mr. Hughes, when are you gonna fly around the world again? You gonna fly with Kate next time? You talked to Lindbergh about your round-the-world flight yet?
Mr. Hughes, where's Linda Darnell tonight?
Yeah, please, Mr. Hughes.
Right here.
Right here, Mr. Hughes. That's it.
Are you trying to be more famous than Lindbergh?
You know, fame is supposed to be my turf. LB! If you don't get more distinguished every time I see you.
Oh, you look so
I'm a complete idiot, and I'm sorry.
Forget it.
No, I'm a vain, preening ass without a single redeeming feature.
Well, that's not true. You have very good teeth. Come on.
I've got a better idea. Take me flying. Or better yet, I'll take you flying.
Do your worst, Miss Hepburn.
Some of these days, you're gonna miss me, honey. Some of these days.
Don't be so squirmy, Howard. You're gonna get on famously with father and mother. And I'm sure they'll like you, too, once they get to know you.
You'll be so sorry when I'm away. Now you're gonna be lonely, just for me only. Cause you know.
Kathy!
Sweetheart, who's that with the camera right there?
Oh, that's my ex-husband, Ludlow. Father and mother are just mad about Luddy.
What the hell is he doing here?
Oh, he's here all the time. Hello? Sorry we're late, Mom. Oh, Dad.
Darling.
Uncle Willie.
Oh, who we got here? Don't feel self-conscious.
Heaven, attention, please. This is Howard.
Howard, welcome. Don't worry, he's had his lunch.
He likes you. It's unusual.
We pay our devotion to the arts here, a colony we created. Julian's a painter. Abstract, of course. What the hell's the point of painting something real when you can just take a picture nowadays, don't you agree? Where do you stand on politics, Mr. Hughes?
Excuse me?
We're all socialists here.
Oh, we are not.
We're all the other people to ask.
Now, you've met Mr. Roosevelt. What make you of him?
What are you sniggering at?
What? What was that?
You just sniggered.
No. The dog, it seems to be crushing my feet.
Oh!
Oh, my God.
Buster!
Hey!
Don't you like dogs?
Man, I will not have you sniggering at Mr. Roosevelt at my table. Please leave.
No, I wasn't.
I thought everybody liked dogs.
Well, perhaps he had a bad experience as
a child. Kathy, does it sicken your craw that Howard here gets more press than you do?
A bad experience with a dog?
No.
You are such a shy creature.
Perhaps it was a very large dog.
Well, you make fun, but the press can be a damned nuisance when all you want to do is...
Was it a Doberman?
Burn my dope. My dope.
Doberman, Mr. Hughes, or a Dachshund?
Neither, sir.
Dachshund's a little dog, set dear.
I'll be lined up against the wall and shot. Just some. What's that? That Spanish painting?
The Goya.
Goya, of course. Yes. Yes, Mexicans. Poor land.
We're not shooting anyone. Not even the press. Anyway, that's the vulgar press, I'm sure. Do you read much, Mr. Hughes?
I try to stay up to snuff on the trade journals. Yeah.
Snuff.
These would be flying magazines.
What? What was that?
Oh, he's a little damp.
Pass the goddamn butter, I beg you.
You read flying magazines.
Take the butter.
Trade journals on engineering, aviation.
We read books.
Well, Howard has to read the trade pieces, Mom, because he's designing a new aeroplane.
Oh, really? Do tell.
Well, it's quite exciting, actually. It's a spy plane for the Air Corps. A twin-engine plane with some... I must admit, some rather unique design features. You see, it has these two booms,
Lenny built a birdhouse once. You remember that, dear?
Yes, well, a mere trifle, darling.
Oh, I remember the painting. The painting, it's called May 18 or something. Anyway, Goya is vastly overrated.
All the Spaniards are.
Nonsense, Picasso is sacred.
I'm a urologist.
It was quite aesthetic, really.
A sacred monster, that's what Picasso is.
The birds didn't care for it much, but the bats do.
I'll bet.
Oh, that's such bats.
You speak up, dear.
Nothing, Mrs. Hepburn, nothing.
Then why did you speak? I can't abide people who speak but have nothing to say.
Did you go to mechanic school to learn all this, you know, airplane guff?
No, I didn't, Luddy, no.
Well, Howard just flew around the world in 3 days, don't you know?
I think
we've
had enough about airplanes. And dogs, apparently, had a
bad. Then how'd you make all that money?
We don't care about money here, Mr. Hughes.
Well, that's because you have it.
Would you repeat that?
You don't care about money because you've always had it.
Well, then how did you make all that?
Excuse me, I'm speaking.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
Some of us choose to work for a living. Speaking of which, I have more of that airplane guff to tend to. Excuse me.
Well, seems a rather high-strung chap.
You're a fine bunch of bullies, aren't you?
Have you talked to Mr. Mayer about letting you do Jane Eyre?
Oh, the old Philistine won't budge. Too arty, don't you know? Daddy, I'm convinced the man hasn't met anything longer than a Sunday Katzenjammer kids in his life.
No fair kicking. You have to use the mallet. Really, though, darling, you can't retire from the field of battle like that or they'll never respect you.
Katie, I don't understand. You're like a different person in there.
Oh, they just expect me to be a certain way. There's only one real Cate. And that's your Cate.
And over in Hollywood, aviation tycoon Howard...